On any afternoon, at McKelligan Canyon, you'll find people riding their bike, walking, or just taking in the view.
I like coming to McKelligan Canyon because of the beautiful scenery. It's a way to step away from reality for a bit and become one with nature.
Natalie has been coming out here for about a year now, something experts say is pretty common.
Hiking has become a very popular way to exercise and explore the beauty that the El Paso Mountains has to offer for us. Rick Labelle tells us more about what to expect when hiking.
As far as dangers are concerned, snakes are not really that dangerous unless you try to pick up a rattlesnake. And most people, when they hike, they never even see things like snakes because snakes are nocturnal for the most part.
Labelle shows us a rattlesnake that can be found in our area. He says El Pasoans might encounter diamondbacks like this one. If you see a snake, Labelle says, though you may be scared, stay calm.
The thing you should do is leave the snake alone. Just let the snake go by. If any animal, no matter how big it is, if you corner it and if it feels like it's in danger, it's going to try to defend itself.
Labelle says you're more likely to be struck by a meteor than to be bitten by a rattlesnake. In fact, he says snakes are vital to our ecosystem.
And we really need all the snakes out there because mice can carry diseases that can be spread to humans, and of course they eat our food. So they're very important in maintaining the balance of nature.
Diamondbacks aren't the only rattlesnakes that can be found in our area. There are 6 different kinds of rattlesnakes. Hear all about them from an expert on the UTEP campus. Just click on this story on BorderZine.com. Reporting for BorderZine, this is Christian Gonzalez.